UBS loses friends after its results severely underperform. The Swiss bank blaming Facebook's IPO shambles for lower than expected earnings. And BP's pain extends well beyond the Gulf of Mexico. Joining me is Peter Tal Larsen. Let's kick it off with UBS, ruining the day they got involved with Facebook.
Yeah, well, and actually, I mean, they weren't even really involved with Facebook.
Right.
They weren't a lead manager on the IPO. But what they did was they had a load of clients, both in their asset management, their institutional clients, but also private wealth management clients, who wanted to buy Facebook stock. And so they placed all these orders, and they had all these systems set up to make sure that they got the best price. And then something went wrong between UBS and NASDAQ and the orders. So they repeated the orders and repeated them. And in the end, all the orders got filled. So they suddenly were left with a load of overpriced Facebook stock they didn't really want and they had to sell.
What a disaster.
Well, yeah, and it's 350 million Swiss francs. And the point is, they could really have done without this because the second quarter was already quite tough for the investment banking business across the board. And if you strip out the Facebook thing, they kind of did okay. Relative to the competition and relative to what they're doing, which is trying to shrink their balance sheet very quickly.
Yep.
But it's another, after the rogue trading loss, it's another sort of, unfortunate one-off blip in the investment bank. And people will continue to ask, how many more of these are there going to be?
But wealth management seems to be doing okay, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's an interesting paradox, which is that UBS seems to be sort of acting as despite what's going on in the investment bank, seems to be acting as a bit of a sort of safe haven. So clients are taking their money to UBS, probably out of the Eurozone or out of other banks. But the irony is, of course, is that they're taking their money to UBS and they're doing nothing with it, So the flip side of that kind of safe haven trade is that people just want to be in cash, which means that actually UBS earns a lower margin on the money that it has than it did before.
BP, obviously we think deep water, the business there, but it's not just that clearly that's hit this company.
No, well, I think that's what's interesting really about these BP results is that they made a slightly bigger provision for their Gulf of Mexico problem, but their problems are elsewhere. We know about the problems in Russia, but now they've had to take a write down on their U.S. shale gas assets because the gas price is so much lower. They've got this project in Alaska which they've abandoned, and so actually it's not just the kind of core problem; it's also sort of the peripheral problems that are causing them difficulties. Now, if BP was to resolve its sort of overhanging litigation and compensation claims on the Macondo spill, that would lift a cloud off the stock. But I think the point we're trying to make is that there are other things going on within BP that will continue to make life difficult for them.
Okay. Peter, many thanks for that. You can read both those stories, of course, on the Breaking Views website. For more insight, watch our US Breaking Views show. That comes on every day, 12:30 Eastern, 17:30 BST. I'm Axel Throvel. This is Reuters.